Hello, I'm Gauri Joshi from Dr. Kalmadi Shamrao High School, Ganesh Nagar, Pune. The topic which I choose for the abstract is counting combinations. We conducted this activity of counting combinations for students of standard 5, and there were about 240 students. We are 6 computer teachers, and we have 2 computational thinking periods in per week. Now let me take you through my PowerPoint presentation. So now let me tell you about how we have implemented this particular activity, what variation we did in this particular activity, what challenges were faced, and what impact it made on the students. So as a discussion, we started with the term combinations. We asked the students of Standard 5, what do you actually mean by the term combinations? So students gave a quick response about mixing of two colors gives a combination of third. Then also we started with day-to-day examples such as how a teacher is assigning a class monitor, how a mother is packing a tiffin box for her child, how the children are buying ice cream when they go out in an ice cream shop, how they are buying different clothes. So all these examples involved combinations. Now we came across the examples which were included in CS Pathshala curriculum and also in a book called as Coding Sanskrit. The examples were combination of clothes, combination of blocks, pizza topping was a new example, and the combination of making a fruit salad from Coding Sanskrit too. So students did this particular activities properly. They enjoyed this particular activities, and even they discussed these activities with their friends, and they took these activities outside the classroom also. So now let me tell you how the actually activities were implemented. So in this particular example, which was given in CS Pathshala curriculum, it stated about how student is going to dress up when he is having 2 shirts and 3 trousers. So the students drew a neat diagram showing different types of possible combinations, and they came up with the answer 6, which was correct. Then we went ahead with the example of combination of blocks. This example was also present in CS Pathshala curriculum. The slides and the content was very much useful. The students were able to draw different colored blocks, and they need to put it on one, that is a tower. So how many different towers will you be able to create from the given 3 different blocks? The answer was 6, and the students were able to solve this example correctly. Then the next example we did was about the pizza example, where students were asked to buy a pizza, and in that particular pizza they are supposed to design their own topping. So topping would be designed when 5 different ingredients were given, and they need to select only the 3 ingredients. So the answer that students gave was 10 different topping or combinations can be made. So here we applied the approach of keeping one ingredient common. As you can see here, each time one ingredient is kept common and the other 2 ingredients are repeated. So this was very much easy for the students when we applied this approach, and even the problem was broken down into smaller steps. Then a similar example was done from the book called as Coding Sanskrit, where 5 fruits were given and students are supposed to take 4 fruits from this given 5 fruits and do a fruit salad. So as you can see here, the same approach was applied where one fruit was kept constant and other fruits were repeated. Then we faced, while doing this particular examples, definitely we came across different challenges. So some of the students were not able to do proper combinations. They really struggled. They were not able to reach the correct number of combinations. They couldn't keep the track of how many combinations were done. Are these combinations repeated? Also, students who were with higher order thinking skills, when a problem was put in front of them, they gave the answer immediately with the help of formula. So here, computational thinking aspect was not focused. Then afterwards, we came across a mix of these two particular challenges and also one more challenge. How do we keep the students engaged and how different examples can be designed keeping this particular concept in mind? So we introduced some variations. So in the previous example, which was very hard to understand regarding the fruits, so we thought of why not to give students in hands-on activities where they can actually do the combination with some objects. So we thought of an example of coins where a student has to do a total of 15 with any of the coins that are given in front of him. So a child was able to do create different combinations using these different coins, and the error part of repeating the combinations was avoided. The next example, students are were doing it before the lockdown days, was buying of a combo meal when they used to be at McDonald's. This was a really good example where they could actually relate that how a combo meal can be formed using a combination of different ingredients given. Then we had the example of pizza toppings, the same we repeated. And here one more example was modified about the fruits. As previously said, the five fruits were given, and out of five fruits, four fruits were to be selected for the fruit salad. So instead of fruits, we changed this particular example. Now instead of fruits, we introduced them the digits. Here the digits 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 were given to them, and from this available four digits, student have to form a number. And the number is the nothing but combination of this particular three digits. So this example motivated the students having higher order thinking skills, and they came up with certain conditions. Are we supposed to repeat those digits? And is the order going to matter, as the number 1, 2, 3 and 3, 2, 1 are two different numbers. So definitely order is going to matter in this particular example. Then what actually impact it had on the students? So as we all know that children enjoy CS Pachala activities, the content and lesson plan really helped us to take such different activities. So in the previous example, as I mentioned, breaking down of the problem into different smaller steps was a good solution for me, as the problem of five fruits was not easily understood. And when we broke down it into smaller sets or smaller tasks, the problem was easily understood by the students and they solved it more easily. Then I would like to focus that when computational thinking is involved, we are more into developing the skills to how to solve a problem rather than to apply how the formulas are or how predefined functions work, which may restrict their original thinking. Then we also see to it that the child is not only solving the examples that are textual or that are in the syllabus. We also encourage them to solve the examples that are outside that are related to their real life problems. So in short, I would like to say here that during this activity, I slightly touched upon all the four cornerstones of computational thinking. Say for example, decomposition approach was applied, as the students were able to break down the task into smaller manageable units. Then abstraction also played an important role, because only the focus was on relevant information which has to be taken from the question. Then we were trying to solve similar problems and trying to make connections in that particular topic, which is nothing but pattern recognition. And at the last, to solve the real life problems using systematic approach is nothing but algorithmic thinking. So in this particular way, we touched all the four cornerstones or all the four pillars of computational thinking. And this was really a good opportunity that CS Pachala has provided us. And I would like to thank Mrs. Mrudula Atle Madam also for guiding me in my presentation. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Good afternoon, one and all. I am Lakshmi Dukka from East Godavari District, Andhra Pradesh. I have been working as an IT CT skill trainer at Social Welfare School in Godi, Allavaram Mandalam. The main objective of these social welfare schools are to provide quality residential education for the economically backward children from 5th grade to intermediate. Total 553 girl students from my school are getting benefits from social welfare department. My job role comes under Naipuni Vikasam project, which belongs to Andhra Pradesh State Skill Development Corporation along with ICA Educational Skills Private Limited. I am very glad to have this opportunity to share my experience in this conference. Coming to my activity, the title of my activity is Pyramid Puzzle as a Game. My school, Andhra Pradesh Social Welfare Residential School and Junior College for Girls in Godi. I have tried this game with 5th grade students. Firstly, 6 students as a small batches have participated. Remaining students have taken part later. As per my timetable, I am getting 1 period to teach computational thinking per week. I used PPT to teach the concept of solving pyramid puzzle as mentioned in the curriculum and also given few puzzles to the students for solving. Students have solved in their notebooks but not with full of interest, instead they felt bored. I thought to change their bored feeling in solving puzzles. It is the main reason behind this game. I came up with the idea of paper glasses and sticky notes which are available at that moment in my lab. I wrote numbers on the sticky notes, then I have pasted those sticky notes to the paper glasses. Later, I drew a pyramid puzzle with a piece of chalk on the floor in our lab. I gave a demonstration on how to play the game. Then I kept the glasses with numbered sticky notes in front of students to start the game. Imagine that the game which we are playing alone is different from the game with our friends. So that to make the game more interesting, I asked the students to form as 2 batches of 3 each. By this, they'll get the competitive spirit. The challenge I have faced is asking children to solve the puzzles using paper glasses. Why? Because children can easily solve the puzzles in their notebook. My students also have solved the puzzles in their notebooks. But here, they need to build a solved pyramid with glasses. The variation I have included in this game is 2 levels. First, they have to build a pyramid with paper glasses. Second, they have to fill the puzzle drawn on the floor. The batch who form the pyramid will also get the chance to solve the puzzle on the floor. Here are the images of this activity. As I have discussed till now, they have to identify the numbers on the paper glasses. Then, by using those, they need to form a pyramid. Who will form the pyramid first using paper glasses, they'll get the chance to fill the puzzle on the floor. The impact of this activity is, this activity will help students to improve their reasoning ability, which is very important in our competitive world. Through the numbered sticky notes, students can develop their counting skills. Students also exhibited their enthusiasm to participate in this game. Students also started recognizing shape visualization and formation of patterns like pyramid. This activity makes students to feel fun in solving their problems. Here is the sample video which exhibits the intention of this activity. Let's watch the video. the entire fifth grade students shown their enthusiasm to participate in this game, and also they enjoyed a lot. And they started playing this game in their break times and also in their free time. Thank you for this opportunity. Especially conveying my thanks to Sonia ma'am and Vipul sir, my mentor Premlata Shahji ma'am, and my state coordinator Ranjit sir and Surendra sir, my district coordinator Manikanta sir, and also thanks to Veda ma'am. Thank you to all who have encouraged me and supports me to participate in this conference. Finally, thank you to CS Pathshala, APSSDC, ICA Educational Skills Private Limited. Thank you one and all.